my intention is to make some sort of a difference to the planet. So to leave the planet in some way in better shape than it was when I came in. When I was growing up, I grew up surrounded by creative people. So unwittingly, I really, you know, you just get to see people making stuff and making their living through what they do. So it's just seeping in, you know, and it's in the air. So, but then probably when I first started to see Picasso's work and learning about his life and seeing all the different ways he used to work, you know, painting and sculpture and working with bronze and working with found objects and, you know, printmaking. And, you know, I used to think, well, he is really, the way he works and the way he explores the adventure, you know, the adventure of his life, I really loved that. I loved that he didn't seem to be caught up in any one particular thing. There is no typical day, for starters. So if I'm working on an exhibition, then my whole, every fibre of my being is focused on that. And I don't say that lightly. I mean, I forget to pay bills, I forget to buy food, you know, I'll get up, and I don't quite go out in my pyjamas, but I'll throw some clothes on, I'll take my breakfast out to the studio, and so I'm working. So I make a model. I don't always make a model. And I will do drawings, though I don't always do drawings. But I'll start to work with the wire, and so it's an expanded mesh, so it you can twist it and bend it. And it's stronger than chicken wire, so it's got a kind of, you know, rigidity to it. And so you can you make shapes, and then once the shapes are ready, then I fiberglass them. And then once they're fiberglassed, once that's ready, then we can tile it. And so I work with a team because it takes a lot of patience. And luckily, I work with people who have a lot of patience. And I'm quite patient, but I'm actually more impatient than patient. Oh, I love Angel. Yeah, I love her. She's really, I mean, I cut my teeth on Angel. So I went from being a studio potter to having to then invent, to risk it all. So when I took on that project to make a sculpture for the front moat of the National Gallery on St Kilda Road, so every one of those words is loaded, you know, the National Gallery, St Kilda Road, really a major, you know, position. I almost said no because I thought, I just can't do this. You know, this is going to really, I just don't have what it takes. And then when I thought, well, actually, how often do you get offered these opportunities? Let's go for it, especially when I was 27. So, and then I just went, I'm willing to fail. I'm willing to give it all and to fail if that's how it goes, but to give up the opportunity, you know, I thought I better go for it. And at the end of that project, then it was anything is possible. I really, really saw if I can do this from not knowing anything, anything's possible. Through the Forest, really my version of just delightful things that you can, you know, explore. I haven't done a show like this. I'm quite excited about, you know, what we'll be seeing, and the work's looking lovely, if you ask me. I love it. I'm Deborah Halpin, and I'm an artist. I'm a sculptor, printmaker, painter, glass worker, bronze worker. You know, that's who I am.